We kick off our show with an election update. Democrats will maintain a razor-thin majority in the Senate as pro-abortion Catherine Cortez Masto was declared the winner in the Nevada Senate race after a long slog of vote counting. Majority Leader Chuck Schumer calls the midterms a victory and a vindication for Democrats. Minority Leader Mitch McConnell describes the extremely narrow margins in both the House and Senate as confirmation of a closely divided nation. We spoke to Republican Senator James Lankford of Oklahoma earlier this week to get his thoughts on the new landscape on Capitol Hill. Joining me now is Senator James Lankford of Oklahoma. Senator, thanks for joining us. Congratulations on your reelection. I want to speak with you first about the abortion issue. What do you think is the best course of action for the Senate moving forward on this? Senator Graham has introduced a bill that would stop abortions at the point when babies feel pain. You represent a state that has essentially banned abortion, gone even farther than that. So do you think that that 15-week limit is strong enough?
So to me, it's not strong enough on this, but that's going to be a state-by-state decision on this. So there's going to be two different levels of argument on it. One is each state is going to have to be able to come to where they are as a state. What do you value as children? Some states don't value the life of children at all. They think some children are disposable and some children are valuable. And so they're going to have very different issues on this. And so culturally within that state, there's going to have to be a conversation on how they're going to do this. But also nationally, we're going to have arguments as well. Years ago, nationally, we banned what's called partial birth abortion because the country thought that was a horrific procedure. And even years ago, when Roe v. Wade was still in place, our nation banned partial birth abortion. We're going to continue to be able to have that argument to say, as a nation, what point do we say as a nation, no matter what your state is deciding, we as a country think that's too far. Mm. Now, what Lindsey Graham has brought up is basically a late term abortion bill to say at the very end that when this child is most certainly viable and can feel pain, are we going to still have abortions even at that point? So there's that national argument to be able to determine at what point is this too far, no matter what state that you're in. But in each state, there's going to be a different argument as well as what we see. So quite frankly, what the court has done in the Dobbs decision is push this back out to the people to be able to have the argument about how much does our culture value life. Mm-hmm. And I believe we should value the life of every single child. Let's have that dialogue.
I appreciate your take on that. And obviously, Republicans did not win as many seats as a lot of people projected, but they do seem to have won back the House. What can we expect the dynamic to be on Capitol Hill during these next 2 years, especially when it comes to advancing pro-family, pro-life policies?
So I think this is still going to be this ongoing national dialogue. I think the House is going to have one set of conversations. The Senate will have another one, obviously, with Democrats in control of the Senate. They've been very outspoken that they want to advance and increase abortions in America. The House will now be in a position to say, no, we need to decrease it. That's going to at least cause people across the country to be able to talk about how do we value children. We forget on the partial birth abortion ban. That took a very long time to be able to actually put in place as we as a nation talked about it. There were several failed votes in that process. We now look at it as a culture and think, I can't believe that we ever allowed partial birth abortion as a country. Why, this is such a no-brainer, but it took a while to be able to get to that spot. So I think we're going to have that same kind of dialogue now nationally, and we're going to have that same dialogue locally. So I encourage people not only to get involved in volunteering in pregnancy resource centers and finding ways to be able to support moms and dads in those crisis moments, but also in education, talking about it with your children, talking about it with community groups and with college groups. They need to discuss this issue of life. If you're at all articulate in this issue, you need to get out and be able to talk about it. But it also needs to be working on your local legislatures as well in your states to be able to make decisions locally. So again, it's a multifaceted conversation centered around this one thing. Are children valuable? I believe that they are. So let's have that dialogue.
All right. Well, Senator James Lankford of Oklahoma, thanks so much for joining us. Appreciate your time.
Glad to do it.